Hi all, I hope you all are safe at your place. Now I am going to be highlighting a unique website that is ansplash.com. What is the uniqueness of this site in the sense? If you want to download your beautiful free images and pictures without paying any single amount, make a difference on the site. Ansplash is a website dedicated to sharing a stock photography under the Ansplash license. Since 2021, it has been owned by the Getty Images. The website claims over more than 2 lakhs of contributing photographers and generates more than 70 billion photos impressions per month on the growing library of the 2 million photos. Ansplash has been cited as one of the world leading photography websites by Forbes, Entrepreneurship Magazine, CNET, Medium, and The Next World. So from this particular site, we can download the plenty of free images without paying any amount. Suppose if you want to prepare a PPT or e-content, generally we are depends on the net sources. But generally the problem with net images which we have downloaded, most of the images are come under the copyright issues license based. So, but this particular website, it provides a CC BY license, that's for Creative Commons open license. You can use that images for preparing your PPT as well as the e-content development. Without having any kind of issues, you won't face any kind of copyright issues in the future. And the license which they provide for us, just I'm going to list out the licenses. Ansplash photos are made to be used freely, so they provide the three conditions and three things for us. All photos can be downloaded and used for free. It means that we can download all the photos which is available in the Ansplash website. And the second one, commercial, non-commercial purpose also we can use it. The third important one, no permission is needed. So if you are using any images from the Ansplash website, there is no need to ask the permission to the photographer which they took the photos, right? Those who are uploaded the photos in the particular sites. So you don't need to get any permission to them. But if you are giving the attributions, appreciated. Suppose you are preparing the PPT, you can give the acknowledgements in the end of the slides. So I'm moving for my full demonstration of the sites, how we can effectively use the site, how we can download these images for the future purpose for preparing the PPT as well as the preparing or developing the e-content materials. So for reaching this website, we can type Ansplash, the spelling for Ansplash, ENSPLASH. After typing the term Ansplash in the Google, we can enter it. Once you click the enter, it lists the next page. After this, you can see this first website, ansplash.com. So you can see this other important terms which they provide here. Ansplash is a beautiful free images and pictures. If you want to download the images, and we can use the images for any projects, like they given some kind of descriptions. And if you want to reach this particular sites, click once again the Ansplash, beautiful free images of the search results. Then this is a website looking. So this is a user interface view of the website of ansplash.com. So this is a URL, ansplash.com. And the first thing, as a first time user of this particular site, we have to go for a sign up or the join free. So you don't need to pay any amount for creating account. It's a free sign up only. For the sign up, you can go for the join free. Once you click the join free, it leaves the next interface. Even you can join this particular account through the Facebook with the use of the Facebook account. Otherwise, you can create a new account. You can give your first name, last name, and email address. Then finally, you can generate this kind of username and password. So don't forget the username password which you created from your end. After this, click as a join. Once you click the join, it leads the next page. So for my end, I'm already created an account. Therefore, I'm going to go for the login. Once you click the login, it has the login credentials. So I'm already given my username as of the password. Then after that, I click the login. Once I click the login, so it has the mail ID. So I'm giving my mail ID here. So once I give the mail ID, that password is already in down. I'm clicking the login. Once I click the login, it goes to my login page. See, this is my login page. So after logging into, suppose you like to add your photos, and if you want to do any kind of personal settings in the particular account, you can click this right corner. If you want to change any settings here, go to the view profile, And the view profile, if you want to add the photos, you can add it here. And if you want to edit other, particularly for username as well as the display name, if you need to be changed, you can change it from here. Then otherwise, go down, there is option called account setting. They are given lot of account setting options. Suppose if you want to explore these things, you can explore from here. Then after that, if you want to go back to the home view of the Unsplash.com, so go to the left corner, you can see the small icon of the Unsplash website, that's for home option. Once you click home, automatically it goes to the home page. Suppose if you like to search any images or photos, what you have to do, you can search the photos from this search box of the top left corner. Otherwise, you can type the key terms in the center button, in the center search box also they provide. And they are highlighted already, the search for high resolution photos. It means that we may get the high resolution photos, HD quality photos we might through this website. And suppose if you want to check what kind of photos are available in this particular website, what you have to do, there is an view all options in the right corner. If you click the view all, you can see the different headings. This is like an album. So different headings albums are available. For example, in the case of the wallpapers, nearly 7.3k contributions. In the case of the nature, 8.9k contributions. So every albums having, they're given some kind of description about what is that album, the photos is describing, as well as the how many people are contributing. So like this, they're given lot of albums. So this is one way we have to check the images which are already available here. Otherwise, suppose if you want to check separately wallpapers instead of going to the view wall, you can click the wallpapers. Once you click the wallpapers, you can see the wallpapers which is available in the next sources. See this much of wallpapers are available. Then similarly, if you want to find the nature images, click the nature images. They're given some kind of description about the nature. And in the right side, you are seeing the status, then contribution, top contributors, the details also available. You are seeing the lot of images of the nature. So like this, you can go with different heads based images. Suppose I like to find the images of the laptop of preparing one of my PowerPoint. Therefore, I'm typing as the key term is a laptop. Suppose I like to download the images related to the laptop images. Therefore, I'm typing as a laptop in the right corner, in the left corner. Once I type the laptop in the search box, once I click enter, I can find the plenty of images. See how much images are available. And all the images are very high picture quality. So this much of images are available. If you go down, you can find the plenty of images are available. Suppose I like to download some images. Particularly the first image I like to download, what I'm going to do, I am clicking the center. Once I click the center, you can see this option. This is for the like. Suppose you like this particular images, you can give us a like photo. Like so whenever you are finding anything in the YouTube or the Facebook, we are giving the thumb symbol, no, like in this manner they're given short symbol. Suppose you want to keep this particular images as part of your collections of your images, you can click this add collections. Once you click the add collection, it to create your collections name, you can create and then keep this particular images on particular folder. It's like a folder creation zone. Suppose you like to download this particular images, they provide the lot of options to download. If you click the download in the right corner, there's a small arrow mark. The original size of the image is 5000 to 4000. Suppose you like to download the small picture or medium or the large picture, you can go with this. Otherwise, go with the original size photos, which is available here. Once I click the original size, automatically the images may download it. See, so it may download it in the left corner. It may available in our downloaded folder of your system automatically. Then I'm going to explore the other features. So if it comes down, the same image description they provide, how many people have viewed these images, how many people have downloaded these images. And if you want to know more about this particular images, if you click the info, you can see these options, how many people have views, how many people have downloaded, and which camera. So in this particular image, they're not giving any kind of descriptions who took these photos and all. And some of the other images they highlight in post with the photo, in which camera they used, so everything they describe here. And suppose you'd like to explore the free to use the under the Unsplash license, which are the options they provide, which are the freedom they provide to us. Once you click here, it's list the next page. There you can see the ANSPAS photos are made to be used freely. Our license reflects that all photos can be downloaded and used for free. So it means that we can download these photos. Then the second one, commercial, non-commercial purpose. So even we can download these materials, you can use for your PPT presentation or for your candidate development or any other projects which you already which you are undergoing. Then that after that you can go for the commercial purpose or non-commercial purpose also, the particular images. And there is no permissions needed to download the particular images for use the images for your end. But if you like to give the attributions, it's appreciated according to them. And what is not permitted? Photos cannot be sold without any significant modification. It cannot be sell after changing any modifications in this particular images. Then comparing photos from ANSPLAS to replicate similar or competing service is not possible. So this is there's two things we cannot do in the case of this ANSPLAS license. Even though the attribution is not required, ANSPLAS photographer appreciate it as provides ensure to their work and encourages them to continue the sharing. So if you are giving some kind of acknowledgements in the end of the PPT or in part of your, in the end of your e-content materials, so the contributors may happy, then fine, it may give some kind of motivation to share much images in this particular site. So this is the license options I provide ANSPLAS. So once again, I'm going back to the homepage of ANSPLAS.com. Once I go to the ANSPLAS, so I can see the home pages. Once again, I'm going to type as a laptop. So previously I typed here as a laptop. Suppose I like to type here, I'm typing as a laptop. So once I give the laptop, even we can go for this some kind of advanced search also they provide here. One is called any working page. Suppose you like to download the images only the landscape, you can go to the landscape. Suppose you like to go with portrait or a square, which orientation size is needed, you can select it. Suppose I like to go with the landscape, I'm selecting the landscape. Similarly, there is another option called any color. Suppose you like to find any images on some specific color, you can select the color. Similarly, there is a sort by relevance. Suppose you want to download the image based on the newest, or if you keep any relevance, you can select it here. Just I am moving to the down, so a lot of images are available. Once again, I'm going to tell how to download these images. Suppose I like to download this image. Even you can download these images from this download icon, this one way. If you want to like, you can click this like. If you want to add any kind of collections, you can click the plus symbol. Suppose I like to download this one. I want to explore more about these images. I can go back to this view and you can see these images information. So if I click the info, I can see this the informations. Nearly this much of people's are views, and nearly 76,458 people are downloaded. And this particular image is captured by the Canon camera, the model Canon EOS 500D. The focal length of this camera 44.0 mm, then shutter speed 1/50 per second, then ISO 640. The dimension of this original image 4752 into 3160. So a lot of information is available. Suppose you like to share these images, you can click and share to the people. So if you like to share, then other things. So even we can see these people, those who are taking this photo, that's called Cookie the Po. So he's the person who took the photo. Suppose if you want to find the images like the same kind of images, you can comes down, you can find out the similar images in the down. Suppose you like to download these images also, you can click here and then once again go for the download. Once you click the download, automatically that image may download. So now see, it's downloading. Then after that, you can find these images from your download folder in your desktop. So this is the way we have to use this particular site, and there is no limitation for downloading the images. You can download n number of images as you like. So this kind of images, it might helping you a lot for preparing a very colorful and attractive PowerPoint presentation, as well as the, suppose if you want to prepare any kind of e-content development as part of the preparing any video, you can use some of the images from these sites, and based on these images you can prepare the e-content. Damn sure the websites providing the images, no, it making much attractions while preparing any kind of PPT or any kind of e-content development. And suppose you have the good skill or good competency to take your photos from your end, Suppose you like to contribute also, there is here option they provide. So if you click the submit a photo, it has to be submit your photos and they has to be joined with their some kind of agreement they're asking. Then after joining this agreement, you are also able to contribute any number of images as you like in this particular platform. So this is a platform for both uploading as well as the downloading. Hopefully this website may help you a lot to lead your further academic work. Thank you all. We'll meet the next video. Bye.